from you, but you're on the television. I'm not sure if you're used to it or not.
It's very strange being a guest, but can I say the pastoral care backstage is fabulous.
Wonderful.
I've got water, I feel very well taken care of.
Well, people always say we don't supply breakfast on breakfast, so we thought we'd better change that up for you too.
I made
Hilary
these
loves
things.
Eating on camera.
Well, continuing our big 25th birthday celebrations, we are delighted to be joined by two of our hilarious colleagues.
Hilarious.
Former hosts of Brief. I didn't write this. You'll recognise these laughs.
I'm not being part of this.
Oh my God.
20 past seven on
this is Brandy.
They gave the Kiwi a stripper name. Interesting. No stripper name suggested in yours. Right, it's 8 o'clock. Here's Daniel with the news.
Trump and Clinton. Clinton. Hit show, Saturday Night Live.
Keep going. You do. I can't rescue you.
Stop it, Sam.
Do you think that's one of the things, though? Because it's so early in the morning that anything can set you off at any time.
Well, this is right. And the other thing that people may not realise is you haven't had time to have your breakfast and you've probably had 4 or 5 coffees just to sort of give me that boost. So
you're
anything can
happen.
You're
in a state of delirium.
Absolutely.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And what can go wrong?
A lot. Yeah. As we've seen, this is one of the things I've loved about watching the show this morning. There's all these delightful bloopers. And poor Maddie. And, you know, it's testament to the fact that you're prepared to put yourself out there and you don't mind having a bit of fun.
And almost
that a lot of the bloopers involve you.
That's a very nice way of putting it, Hilary. Thank
it's
you.
It's remarkable that you actually still have a career. It is one of the great mysteries of New Zealand television that you are still on
no,
New Zealand television.
We love
Thank you, Jack. It's so nice to have you here. I was thinking it's like walking into your house and two of your exes are sitting on the couch. But it is really nice to have you both here. What do you remember? Because you both, of course, started 2016 together on Breakfast.
Yeah, we did. And look, I think the thing when you are doing a show like this is that you are spending a lot of time with each other as a team.
Yeah.
More than any other show that I've certainly been involved on in television. And so you form those really close bonds. And I think that's really lovely for people who are watching too, because they really do get to know you, warts and all. Because, you know, 3 hours is a long time on TV.
And I think that was one thing we always took quite seriously, and I know you guys take seriously as well. For a lot of Kiwis, these are the first voices that people hear every day. And there's a real intimacy in broadcasting to people's homes early in the morning, and you're kind of responsible for getting people in a mood to tackle the day. And I think that's something we always took, you know, relatively seriously, which meant that we always tried to have fun at work. You know, we were aware that, you know, when you're dealing with the news and stuff, often there's quite a lot of heavy things happening in the world, but actually being in a position where you can give people, you know, a bit of a laugh first thing in the morning is a real privilege.
Because you started on Breakfast like Maddie and I did in our times, and it has changed though, hasn't it? Even seeing those clips from 2016, which is not that long ago, it even looks a bit more formal then, whereas we're so relaxed now about stuff.
Look at I'm in the couches.
Sometimes I'm too relaxed.
But don't you think that says something about New Zealand as a whole, how we've all moved?
Yeah, I think so. I remember I started in 2006 as a 19-year-old on Breakfast.
I started in 2000. I'm still really behind that, Jack.
And you know, I remember, you know, for us to go and do a live cross somewhere to broadcast from a different part of New Zealand, it was an enormous operation. We'd have to go and set up satellite dishes and all sorts of things. And now, of course, technology has changed, so we're able to go from lots of different places much more easily, which means that we can interact with viewers much more than we used to, which I think is one of the great things about how the show's developed.
You were here for the 10th birthday celebrations and the 21st celebrations.
The 10th birthday. On Breakfast 10th birthday, we did a road trip, and the producer made me do a bungee jump out of a helicopter live on TV, which I nailed. But then,
of course.
But then, yeah, so humble. And then they accidentally dropped me in Lake Wakatipu afterwards.
And it was
August, so it was so cold. And then they pulled me out of the lake, and I was like hypothermic. And I rushed back to the hotel, and I remember I hadn't bought a change of pants. And so I was sitting on the end of my bed with a hairdryer, just sitting there in my undies, trying to dry my pants. And then the room service person just goes, boom! So that's my enduring memory of the 10th birthday.
Hilary, I wonder, because of course you came from across the road. So what were your...
TV3.
Oh yeah, that place. Yeah.
Across the road.
Yeah. What were your thoughts of Breakfast when you came here to start on the show?
Well, you know, it's always a bit bit of a scary prospect, changing jobs and getting to know new people. And it's like starting a new school. I know lots of kids will be heading off to school today. That's what it feels like when you start a new job. But the lovely thing was, you know, people who work in broadcasting, they're fun. You know, they're a lot of fun.
Oh, yeah.
If you're a fun person, you like fun, you'll find your tribe in a TV newsroom.
Yeah.
So the minute I walked on, I thought, okay, this is my vibe. I felt immediately at home and, of course, had a lovely team to work with
I wondered for you, because you had been newsreading before at TV3, so, and whilst we always did see your personality there, this was maybe the first role where you've really got to be you, which must be wonderful.
It wasn't, because I did work in morning radio for a long time. So that little part of my personality, which is hard to keep a lid on as a newsreader, as you all know.
We know.
That got used to come out. I used to get rid of that part of my personality in the mornings on the radio and then sort of just tone it down for the newsreading. But I much prefer a role where you actually can just be yourself.
Yeah.
You know, it's just easier. Not that newsreading isn't being yourself, but you've got to be serious.
Yeah.
You can't be having a giggle every 5 minutes.
Do you have moments that stand out, like things that you remember specifically from your time on Breakfast?
One of my favourite things that we did was actually a cooking challenge, that My Kitchen Rules challenge that we did.
So we came to your house.
Yes, we had the actual judges, Manu and
Pete.
Well, he's been cancelled now, so he's across
Manu
the road. He's across the road. Manu was there. And that, what a thrill. So they came round to my place and we had this cooking challenge. That was
much
fun.
Brilliant.
I didn't win either. I'm still hurting about that.
Yeah. Although, you did win.
I don't think I did.
No,
Brody
you did.
Won. Didn't Brody
no,
win?
No, I was on Brody's team. We
no,
we
you
lost.
And I did.
We
won.
You won.
But what about her power ravioli? I thought that. Okay, well, there you go.
I love that you still remember the dishes.
The dessert. We stuffed up the dessert.
I think we did. I think we won on the dessert.
See, this is the problem when you work on Breakfast. You basically are in a state of, it's like having jet lag all the time.
Yes.
Or like having like some sort of long COVID or something, and that you've got like brain fog all the time. You've just changed this memory, and you've gone from a positive memory to a negative one. Yeah.
Jack?
Okay, I'm going to go right back to when I very first started with you, Maddie, because Maddie and I started on Breakfast together. Yeah. And it was Guy Fawkes one year, and Paul Henry was the host of Breakfast. And you know, we get so nervous about doing these crosses in the morning and going on TV, you know, because it was
a big
scary thing. Yeah. And I remember I was stuffing around with my earpiece, and there was a technical problem, and I couldn't really hear what the conversation. And then finally, Paul and Pip across to me, and they said, okay, Jack, we'll start off this morning, November 5th, of course. Hey, Jack, what's your favourite cracker? And I misinterpreted the question, and I said, my favourite cracker? Oh, it's probably Mealmate. And honestly, for 5 years, people would just like yell at me in the street, how are your Mealmates, man? How are your Mealmates? Of course, my favourite cracker, they meant, what's your favourite fireworks?
Yes.
I remember, though, didn't you also do your car in a...
I crashed my car.
You crashed your car?
Yes.
Yeah. Sorry, what?
I arranged to... See, I feel like health and safety laws have also changed.
Absolutely. The things we got away with back in the day, we'd never be able to do now.
A lot of your friends would want to crash your car.
Yeah. I've never had a cool car. It's kind of been a consistent theme. But this was even less cool than my current car.
Really?
And yeah, we arranged
it's hard to...
It's hard to imagine.
Yeah.
It's the thing that I always think about is the audience as well, because I feel like, unlike any other show, you have this weird, very intimate relationship with the audience, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And that's because you're on air for 3 hours.
Yeah.
And you want them to be part of the conversation that you're having that morning. So, you know, emails, messages, all of those sorts of things. You know, it's lovely hearing people's feedback and them wanting to be part of the conversation that you're having.
Because we showed the clip of me jumping the old fence at the...
Oh, that brilliant television
moment.
And I was almost arrested. And it just makes me think that 12 years on, people still remember key moments from Breakfast, because I still get asked about those moments. So the audience really invite you into their house, right? And they love being a part of your life and you being a part of theirs as well.
It's very much a two-way relationship, with Breakfast. That's the thing. There's because there's an opportunity as presenters to be really authentic and for people to get to know your true personality, like you were saying, Hilary, I think that's a real two-way street. People feel like they know you, and they do, which is the great thing. So when you finish for the day and you're heading home, often, you know, people will stop and talk to you and say, oh, that was such a funny clip this morning, or da-da-da, or that interview was really interesting. And I just, that's one of the things that I think makes Breakfast such a special show.
And that, yeah, it makes it so unique, doesn't it? Because, you know, you can read the news for years and years, but it's always Breakfast. People want to talk about, how early do you get up?
Yeah,
you
know?
That must be the one thing that you do not miss about this show, though.
No, although, you know, you get on that treadmill of getting your body used to getting up early, and it becomes a habit that you do try and become acclimatised to. The thing is, too, and we always did this as well, we'd complain about it in the newsroom and go, oh, it's 3 o'clock in the morning, what are we doing this for? And the minute you're on air at 6 o'clock, it's just like, I'm so pleased to be here. I've just got up, I'm fresh
going
as a daisy.
People going out
to much more kind of rugged employment than us, right?
Yeah. I feel like we, at the very least, are in a nice warm studio with coffee and like muffins and stuff like that. And there are people doing much harder jobs.
Well, thank you for coming in this morning, and thank you for being such a big part of the last 25 years on Breakfast.
That's lovely of you to say. I think we were a very little part of the last 25 years, but we did love it, and loved working with all of you and my lovely co-host here as well.
It's nice to have you back on. Hilary and Jack, thank you so much. Eat up, by the way.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and there's cake over there as well.
Oh, maybe I'll go for the cake.
Yeah, the cake looks good.
It's quite good.